Hello everyone, today we will discuss another topic under environmental studies and environmental law. This topic is relevant constitutional provisions. We have already discussed in another lecture also, but today we will discuss it again with the specific articles of the constitution with respect to environment protection. List of topics to be covered here is the introduction, then relevant constitutional provisions, which are Article 14, Article 19, Clause 1, Clause G, Article 21, Article 48A, and Article 51A, Clause G. Let's start with introduction. We all know that the protection and environment and the improvement of environment is a constitutional mandate. It is necessary to protect particular environment. It has been included in our constitution of India. So it is a commitment for a country for the ideas of a welfare state. The Indian constitution contains specific provisions for environment protection. The absence of a specific provision in the constitution recognizing the fundamental right to clean and wholesome environment has been set off by judicial activism in the recent times. The Indian constitution now contains relevant provisions to protect environment, which are divided in Part 3, Fundamental Right, Part 4, Directive Principles of State Policy, and Part 4A, Fundamental Duties. These are the some relevant constitutional provisions under Indian Constitution. We will discuss Article 14, which provides for equality, then Article 19, Clause 1, Clause G, then Article 21, Article 48A, and Article 51AG, which talks about fundamental duties of the citizens of India. Let's start with Article 14. Article 14 states that the states shall not deny to any person equality before the law or the equal protection of the laws within the territory of India. The right to equality may also be infringed by government decisions that have an impact on the environment. So basically, Article 14 provides for equality. Everyone is equal before the law and everyone should get the equal protection of law. And if any government decision that have an impact on the environment, that could be considered as an infringement of right to equality. This fundamental right impliedly casts a duty upon the state to be fair while taking actions in regard to environmental protection and thus cannot infringe Article 14. In cases of exercise of arbitrary powers on behalf of the state authorities, the judiciary has played a strict role in disallowing the arbitrary sanctions. Use of discretionary powers without measuring the interest of the public violates the fundamental right of equality of the people. So basically, any state or the authorities of state cannot take actions with regard to environmental protection on their own if they are taking any actions with regard to environment, which is a violation of fundamental right under Article 14, then in that particular case, that particular arbitrary action on behalf of the state authorities has been disallowed by the judiciary. Next article is Article 19, 1 Clause G. All the citizens of India have a fundamental right to carry on any profession or business, trade or commerce at any place within the territory of India under Article 19, Clause 1, Clause G of the Constitution. But this is not an absolute right and thus has reasonable restrictions. All the reasonable restrictions to this fundamental right to avoid the environmental hazards have been laid down under Article 19, Clause 6 of the Indian Constitution. In M.C. Mehta versus Union of India case, certain tanneries were discharging effluents in the holy river Ganga, which was causing water pollution. Further, no primary treatment plant was being set up despite the constant reminders. It was held by the court in this case that to stop the tanneries from working because the effluents drained were 10 times more noxious as compared to the ordinary sewage water which flows into the river. So here we can see that judiciary has taken up a major role to protect our environment and to stop the water pollution. The court ordered while directing tanneries to be stopped from working, which have failed to take necessary steps as required for the primary treatment of effluents from the industries. The court, while passing this order, contended that though the court is conscious about the unemployment that might occur due to the closure of the tanneries, but health, life and ecology holds greater importance in the eyes of law. So here we can see that court upheld the decision and puts the health, life and ecology of under great importance, and unemployment was lowered down with respect to environment. The purpose is to avoid the ecological imbalance and degradation of the atmosphere in the name of carrying on trade, business, occupation or carrying on any profession. Thus, in the name of business or profession, one cannot cause harm to the environment. Another important view has been provided here by the judiciary that although it has been guaranteed under the fundamental right under the Indian Constitution to carry on any trade, business or occupation or profession, but one cannot cause harm to the environment in the name of their business or profession. Next article is Article 21. Article 21 of the Constitution provides for the fundamental right of life. It states that no person shall be deprived of his right to life or personal liberty except in accordance with the procedures established by law. The words "except in accordance with the procedure established by law" can be interpreted to mean that this provision is subject to exception and is regulated by law, which varies from case to case. Right to life includes the right to have a dignified life and also the bare necessities of life like food, shelter, clean water and clothes. The right to live extends to having a decent and clean environment in which individuals can live safely without any threat to their lives. An environment shall be free from diseases and all sorts of infections. This is crucial because the right to life can be fulfilled only when one lives in clean, safe and disease-free environment. Otherwise, granting such a right would prove to be meaningless. This aspect of Article 21 has been evidently discussed in the case of Rural Litigation and Entitlement Kendra, Dehradun. In this particular case, the petitioner along with the other citizens wrote to the Supreme Court expressing their views against the progressive mining which denuded the Mussoorie hills of the trees and forest and soil erosion. This led to the having an adverse effect on the environment and resulted in landslides along with the blockage of underground water channels. An expert committee was appointed in this on behalf of the Supreme Court to advise the Honorable Court with some technical issues. On the basis of the report provided by the expert committee, the court provided that the limestone quarries could to be closed because it was infringing the right to life and personal liberty. Quarrying operation led to ecological degradation and air and water pollution, which affected the lives of the people to a great extent. Next article is Article 48A. In the year 1976, the Constitution was amended. With this amendment, Article 48A was inserted in the Constitution with the aim to afford better provision so as to preserve and protect the environment. The provision of this article imposes the duty on the state to protect and improve the environment and safeguard the forest and wildlife of the country. The word environment has been interpreted widely in this article. The state shall not only play a role of being protectionist, but also enact adequate measures for improvement of the environment. Every natural resource is interconnected with other natural resources of this country. Forests are directly linked with providing pollution-free air, helps in reducing global warming, and is also connected with water resources. They help in maintaining the ecological balance. Thus, this resource is crucial, and hence its protection is equally important to avoid atmospheric pollution. Hence, the specific insertion of this section is justified. Next article is Article 51A, Clause G. Part 4A of the Constitution deals with fundamental duties. There are certain fundamental duties of which every citizen has been provided, and they are supposed to follow these duties. Article 51A, Clause G specifically deals with the fundamental duty of the citizens to improve and protect the natural environment, which includes forests, rivers, lakes, wildlife, and to have compassion for the living creatures. Like the duty of the state, it is the duty of all the citizens of not only protecting the environment but also taking measures which are adequate enough to improve the environment. Nature has gifted us with the resources and a pollution-free environment, and thus this casts a duty upon the citizens to keep these resources in the same condition for future generations. Hence, the principle of intergenerational equity plays a major role in environmental protection by sustainable use of natural resources. In Kinkeri Devi v. State, Himachal High Court held that in Article 48A and Article 51A, Clause G, it was held that it is both constitutional pointer to the state and the constitutional duty of the citizens not only to protect the environment but also improve it and to preserve and to safeguard the forest, the flora, the fauna, and the rivers and the lakes and all other water resources of the country. The negligence to abide by the pointer and perform the duty is nothing, basically the straight betrayal of the fundamental law of the land. In the case of betrayal, the courts cannot remain a silent spectator. A court can intervene at any time to make the implementation of the provisions by issuing writs, orders, and directions as it thinks fit and necessary.